Hi, I'm Jay Ferber. Come on in, check out my writer's office.
Yesterday afternoon, two adult lions escaped from the zoo.
And killed several people in Los Angeles.
This is a new addition we built in the back of my garage about 2 years ago now, I think. Because our house is kind of small and we had a kid on the way, so I needed a place to work and maybe sometimes get away from the kid. And that's what this is. It's my office. It's where I watch movies and TV. It's got a full bath, microwave, fridge. But mostly it's where I do my writing. This is where I spend my days. If I'm not on staff at a show, I'm here working on scripts 5 days a week. Starting out, we got two mementos here. We've got my very first writer's chair from the set of Ringer. That was the first show I was on. We've got another one over here from Starcrossed. The second show I was on. So I just like having those as keepsakes. On Zoo, they didn't have individual writer's chairs. But my mom visited on set one day, so they made one for her. So she has her own chair, but I don't. We've also got my little shrine to one of my favorite shows of all time, The Greatest American Hero. This is a limited edition figure, the cover to an old TV guide, limited edition Lego figure, a little Lego knockoff. We've also got my Magnum PI shelf, which has the Hot Wheels for the cars, the a team ring that my friend Brian Vaughn got me for my birthday a few years back, and they made three of these Magnum PI comic books, graphic novels, hardcovers, for the UK. They made, I think it was 82, 83, and 84, and I've tracked down two of them so far, and I haven't gotten my hands on the third one yet, but they are a lot of fun. Most of these are just books that I've read and enjoy. This shelf here are all books, collected editions of stuff I've written. Up here is a mock cover for Zoo, a Zoo comic book that doesn't actually exist, but my boss has had it commissioned as a wrap gift for the second season of Zoo. And it was created by one of the guys from Comicraft, a comic book lettering service. This is an authentic antique spinner rack that you used to find in pharmacies and corner stores. My wife found one of these on eBay a couple years ago and got it for me for Christmas. And it's filled with singles of all comics I've written. So everything on here is a comic book that I wrote. So I just like every time I get a new box of comps in the mail, I just stick one in here. And that's an idea I stole from, again, from Brian Vaughn, who has the same thing in his office. This is where the magic happens, as I say. I do all my writing on a laptop, but as I got older, my eyes started going, so I got a bigger screen when I'm home. My Superman poster, one of my favorite movies of all time, and such an iconic poster. Kiss Kiss Bang Bang, another favorite of mine. I'm a huge Shane Black fan, and I think that's one of his best in his first movie as a director. Anchorman, all the movie posters you see up here are just movies that I love, all different genres, and Anchorman is one of the funniest movies of all time. I can quote it for days on end. I'm supposed to show you my fridge, which is stocked with nothing but water and Coke Zero, which is what keeps me going throughout the day. I have a cat who I bring out to the office with me sometimes, so she's got her own little setup here with her cat tree and litter box. Big TV, if I'm stuck on a story, I'll frequently just turn on the PlayStation and play Grand Theft Auto for 20 minutes and let my mind roam. And usually whatever is bothering me will shake itself loose once I kind of turn my attention away from it. Here's something else. I haven't found a better place to store this yet, but this is an antique fire helmet that I got from my dad. My dad was a fireman. He didn't actually wear this. This was from before his time, but it's been a part of every place I've lived as an adult since college. So thanks for coming by. You don't have to go home right now, but you cannot stay here. So good to see you. Bye.